A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th August, on the front page you have Pakistan expels Indian envoy, suspends bilateral trade. So this is a further development here. You can see Pakistan has decided to take Kashmir issue to the United Nations and it has decided to observe 15th August as Black Day. But many Jammu residents here, you can see hail integration as best option. And in Jammu and Kashmir, phone and internet connectivity continue to be disrupted. Then below you have RBI takes offbeat tack to help reverse growth slowdown. So you can see equated monthly installments which have to be paid for loans, they will fall after unconventional 35 basis points rate reduction. So here you can see RBI has opted to reduce the key policy rate by 35 basis points. So it will go down to 5.4%. So this will help bring EMIs come down and interest rates come down. So it is saying that this would help revive demand to tackle the deepening economic slowdown in the country. So why is it called unconventional? Is because generally RBI reduces or increases repo rate by 25 basis points, but this is a 35 basis points rate reduction, the key interest rate repo rate reduction, which over the years has been shown here. On page 8 you have overnight traffic ban in Bandipur will stay, rules Supreme Court. So there is a ban on traffic in Bandipur, the road which passes through it. So center has been told by Supreme Court to file an affidavit on a long-term solution on the matter. And it said that the overnight traffic ban on the national highway running through the core area of Bandipur Tiger Reserve will continue. Below you have Center for Amicable Solution to Mekedatu. So Karnataka proposed Mekedatu Balancing Reservoir project, which is there, which has resulted in a controversy. It aims to augment Kaveri water supply for Bengaluru, but it is opposed by Tamil Nadu, which says that it is going to affect the flow of the river downstream. So the Ministry of Environment as such at the central level has given in principle approval for conducting a study of the project. So this has been opposed by Tamil Nadu. It's not been a clearance yet, but at least a detailed project report has been prepared. So that has been approved by the central government. So environmentalists have also raised concerns because it would result in submergence of 52.5 square kilometer of forest land, including core areas of Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. On page 9 you have Center unveils plan for coastal zone management. So Environment Ministry has unveiled a draft plan that will dictate how prospective infrastructure projects situated along the coast ought to be assessed before they can apply for clearance. So this is draft environmental and social management framework, which is part of the World Bank funded project. So it lays down guidelines for coastal states to adopt when they approve and regulate projects in coastal zones. In Karnataka, in Kerala too, we have seen how the coastal project, housing project in Idukki has caused a concern. Supreme Court has asked the buildings to be raised down. And you can see it is said so far three coastal states, namely Gujarat, Orissa and West Bengal, have prepared integrated coastal zone management plans with support from World Bank. And then this is just 83 TMC feet water from Godavari for Tamil Nadu. So this is 1000 million cubic feet. So Tamil Nadu has been allotted just 83 TMC feet of water under the proposed Godavari-Kaveri link according to the draft detailed project report of National Water Development Authority Agency, which is a central government organization entrusted with preparing proposals for linking rivers. So this is the draft report of the body. On the editorial page, the first editorial is blackout. So it says dissent does not have to invite measures aimed at throttling information flow. So Jammu and Kashmir is entirely cut off, and this is government's efforts to completely integrate it with the rest of the country. But then this editorial says that you should not throttle information flow to avoid dissent. And this is RBI's Goldilocks cut. So this is regarding the repo rate cut which RBI has announced now. So this is 35 basis points reduction in the key interest rate, the repo rate. So this says the government must now unleash measures to boost growth. So a rate cut is not sufficient. Steps to boost growth have to be taken as well. Then this is fragility of India's federalism. So this is again in context of Kashmir. It says government's Kashmir move exposes the contingent nature of India's asymmetric constitutional provisions. So you know how it has been a forced integration. And this is Hong Kong adrift and China without an anchor. So we have seen protests in Hong Kong spiraling. And this article says that Beijing, that is China, should realize that political reform rather than economic lures is what resonates in Hong Kong. So they want democracy, they want political reforms, but China is unwilling to go ahead with that. And again, this article on Jammu and Kashmir says, downgraded at the stroke of a pen. So this says the move to convert Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories could open a Pandora's box. So there will be further issues which would arise. And then here you have the big picture on tigers. So it says while the number of tigers has increased, infrastructure expansion plans have totally discounted their presence. So if tigers are increasing, then facilities for them have to be provided for infrastructure expansion, which takes place not taking into consideration the rise in tiger population is a cause of concern. Then on page 13 you have, this is the argument going on in the Ram Janmabhoomi case, but then it's fine. Here you have pilgrims leave for Kailash Mansarovar. So this is regarding the Kailash Mansarovar Yatra, which takes place from India to Tibet. So there has been slight delay in granting visa by China. So now the pilgrims are leaving for Kailash Mansarovar. And below you have, Center puts key airports on alert. So Bureau of Civil Aviation Security has in an alert issued to Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Cochin, Nagpur and Chandigarh airports warned that they could be target of a terrorist attack in view of recent developments in Jammu and Kashmir and additional inputs received. Then on international page you have Hong Kong facing worst crisis since 1997. So Chinese officials say protests are getting increasingly violent and having a broad impact on society. So China may take stringent action here is a concern now. And this is South Korea to pay more to keep US troops on ground. So this is what US President Donald Trump says, over 28,500 soldiers guard South Korea against threats from North Korea. So South Korea has to pay more now is what Trump is demanding. Then on business page you have regarding the RBI reducing the repo rate and taking other decisions, like it has raised the cap on exposure to single non-banking finance companies to 20%. So now banks get more headroom for lending to NBFCs. Also lower risk weight for consumer loans may cut capital needs of banks by 12,500 crores. Then this is transfer funds 24/7 via NEFT from December. So from December, you can transfer funds round the clock using NEFT, National Electronic Fund Transfer Facility. So this has been announced by RBI. Currently, NEFT is available from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. on all working days except 2nd and 4th Saturdays of the month. Then on the last page you have, Mexico's cactus offers alternatives to plastic. So the pulp of this prickly pear is mixed with additives to produce sheets that can be used for packaging. So this is from Mexico. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.